Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. I'm Urvashi and today in this video I'm going to be talking about Jupiter transiting the zodiac sign of Sagittarius from the 5th of November 2019 to the November of 2020. In this 1 year, Jupiter is going to also move into Capricorn from April to June. For about 3 months, Jupiter is going to be in Capricorn and then it will retrograde back to Sagittarius. So that is my topic for today and I'm going to be talking about its conjunction with Ketu here in this zodiac till September next year. So about 10 months of this conjunction. I have already done a video on Jupiter Saturn Ketu conjunction from November to January and you can go back watch that video. I'm going to give that link at the end of this video and in the description below. So this video is dedicated to Jupiter's transit here and Ketu being conjunct in this video in the zodiac, and I'm also going to be covering the ascendants, but I'll do that in the next video, which I would be uploading in a day or two. So before I start, for all those who haven't subscribed, remember to subscribe and remember also to tap the bell icon. So let's see what this conjunction is about. Let's see what Jupiter is doing in the zodiac of Sagittarius. So this is a very positive transit of Jupiter's, because Jupiter owns Sagittarius and Sagittarius is the Mool Trikon sign of Jupiter. Mool Trikon means the official sign. See, Pisces is Jupiter's house, so how are we at home? We are at home in our pajamas and very casual and lazy, but in our official place we are very work oriented, very formal. We want to utilize our time for the maximum productivity. So that is how maybe you can understand the difference between Sagittarius and Pisces. So Jupiter here is all out to give its result in a very positive way, in a very optimistic way, because this is a very optimistic and positive sign, a very adventurous sign, a sign that does not believe in continuing doing what has been done for the last so many years. A sign that believes in change, learning new things, adventure, is optimistic. It wants to continuously grow, continuously learn, continuously change. And so this is definitely a very positive transit. It's the natural house of luck and Jupiter is the natural planet of luck. So the planet of luck in the house of luck, blessing all the ascendants, blessing all the zodiacs. Now, depending on where Sagittarius falls for you, you will get the results accordingly. Jupiter posited in Sagittarius is aspecting Aries, Gemini and Leo. Jupiter's drishti, aspect is called the golden rays, because they are even better than where Jupiter is posited. Because sometimes wherever Jupiter is posited in your chart, there could be an element of carelessness, casualness. You would be careless regarding those things. And but wherever Jupiter aspects, it blesses those things. And though it's great to have Jupiter posited also in the sign, of course it's going to bring a lot of positivity in the house, but the attitude can be a little careless, so that you have to be careful about. I'll try and discuss this when I'm talking about the ascendants. Then we have Ketu joining, in fact Ketu already in Sagittarius. And what does Ketu in Sagittarius mean? So Ketu rules Pisces. Ketu is the co-ruler of Pisces and Ketu is exalted in Sagittarius. Ketu is the natural mokshkarka. Ketu wants us all to go towards moksha. It wants to detach us from all that is materialistic. Ketu owns the natural 12th house of the zodiac and is exalted in Sagittarius, because it wants to help us break free from whatever is binding us. Traditions, values are what bind us, our ideology is what binds us. It wants to break us free from that. So wherever Ketu goes, in whichever zodiac, it wants to break us free from those things in life. And in this 1 year, Ketu is going to help us change our value system, belief system, traditions. Ultimately, it wants to take us towards moksha. But that all depends on how evolved each of us are. We are all at different levels. And how much we want to go towards spirituality. And spirituality is really nothing. It's just being more connected to yourself. It's being more aware of the transitory nature of things. it's being more detached from materialistic things. Of course, we are all living in a very materialistic world. We all have families, we all have children. We can't leave all that and go to the jungles. That is not what spirituality means. Spirituality means being a little detached from all this, understanding that this is all very transitory. If you have something today, you may not have it tomorrow. But what you have is yourself. What you can really have is that inner peace and that inner happiness. And that is the gist of this transit. Because Ketu in Sagittarius wants to break us free from all that is binding us, all that is blocking our growth, all that is hurting us. It wants to take us to a higher level. It wants to take us towards Pisces, you know, that's Ketu's own house. And we are all bound by situations. You know, I get so many mails. Everybody is bound by situations. I'm also bound by my own situations. So we all have our own ideologies. We all growing up in different cultures, in different societies, and every society has their own ideas, philosophy, and we are all bound by things. Somebody could be in a bad marriage and they could be thinking, no, I cannot get out of this marriage because of these reasons. What will other people say? This is not what happens in our society. Somebody could be stuck up in a bad job and they would be thinking, no, I cannot leave this job. My boss is horrible. He insults me every day. There is no growth. I'm stuck. I'm working so hard. But what do? I can't survive without the money. You are bounding yourself by what you have learned all your life. By learning that you need to take care of all this. This is your responsibility. And a job is the sole way of, going about it. So sometimes we bind ourselves because of, you know, things that are in our mind, our own ideologies, our philosophies, things that we have learned over a period of years. Maybe it's a certain lack of confidence. Maybe it's the 8th house issues, the sign of Scorpio. That is where Jupiter is, you know, currently transiting in. And that is the transformation I have been talking about in my previous videos, where I talked about going from a cocoon to a butterfly, where I said you need to break free and you need to suddenly start flying. So maybe the fears are hidden inside of us. We feel a lack of confidence. We feel, no, we cannot manage without this job. No, I cannot venture out and do something of my own. No, I'm not smart enough. I'm not good enough. No, I cannot be outside this marriage. I cannot be living without somebody. I need somebody. I need an anchor. So those could be our fears. So it's time, whatever is binding you, whatever is stopping you, or it could be just you wanting to go be more spiritual, more connected to yourself and your own, you know, psychological issues binding you. Maybe wrong things that we've done in the past are binding us, are holding us, are making us feel small, are not letting us go towards the next realm. And we all do those bad things and we all learn and we all move on and we all should move on. But this is the time when Jupiter moves from Scorpio to Sagittarius. It crosses that Gandhanta, and the Gandhanta is the point of change. It's the difficult point. It's the point of transformation. So there are three Gandhantas, in fact. There are three sets of zodiacs in the zodiac belt. The first four, you can see them as you growing up, being a child, being taken care of by your mom. The next four, you can see them as you going out to the world, getting married, getting a job, working. The last four is you realizing your values and ideologies and what is really important in life. You making an effort, your karma, not profession, karma, your effort, your making a network circle, you're valuing other people, you valuing not just materialistic gains, you valuing people, and then giving away, sharing with others, letting go, expenditure. So this change from the materialistic situation to the higher realm is the Gandhanta point here, the difficult transformation, the difficult change. So whatever ideologies we are stuck up with, this is the time when Ketu comes into Sagittarius. It will help us break free from those ideologies. It wants to help us break free from those ideologies. And Jupiter also being there now for the next 1 year, the Lord of Sagittarius, conjunct Ketu, suggests that we will now have to change our ideologies, have to change our philosophies and belief system. And if you're not ready to do that, then we may be pushed into a corner. If it was just Jupiter alone in Sagittarius, then it was a very optimistic, positive, happy-go-lucky, adventurous kind of a transit. You would have maybe experimented something, thought about it, been happy just thinking about it. But having Ketu here is like it's going to be pushed to you. You may be forced to make decisions. You may have go through circumstances that will make you make those decisions. So it's like taking a bitter pill, but something that will help you in the long run. It's a positive change. It's a good change. Now, like I said, it could also be spirituality, depending on where we are in our lives. So there is another aspect to this transit that I would like to discuss here. Ketu is the significator of introspection, meditation, and internalization. Jupiter is happiness, knowledge, wisdom, wealth, of course. So Ketu here suggests that we internalize that. We find that inside of ourselves. We find happiness, wealth, knowledge, wisdom. We internalize all that and find that happiness inside instead of looking for that happiness outside. So how do we find that happiness inside? By certain ideas. It's those ideas that we follow that, you know, give us happiness inside. By being oblivious to the difficulties that changes will have around us. Whatever changes that will happen around you, if you kind of detach yourself from them a little bit, just a little bit, and try and find that happiness inside, is the best way to utilize this transit, because then this change is going to be very easy for you. The second thing this transit suggests, this conjunction suggests, is Ketu is a planet of intuition. So if you use your intuition the next 1 year, the next 10 months in decision making, because Jupiter is a planet for wisdom, it's our wisdom that helps us decide, it helps us to come to conclusions. And Ketu is that small voice inside, you know, that small voice that is telling you, no, do this. You may not find any logic in what that small voice is saying, but that is what Ketu is. That is your intuition telling you something. And if you listen to that small voice, it may take you towards the right direction. This is an year of intuition. Use your intuition as much as possible. Wherever, try it on smaller things first and see how it works. And if you see it's working in a big way, then use it in the bigger decisions, and you will see your, you know, life going about a major, major change. So this is a very, very positive transit, Jupiter Ketu conjunct in Sagittarius, to bring about the right changes in our lives, to change our belief system, to break us free from all that is binding us, and to take us to our real calling, to put us in our life's path. Because, look at the planets. Saturn is in its own house in Capricorn from January onwards. Ketu is exalted. Rahu is exalted. So Rahu Ketu axis in Gemini, Sagittarius, you know, suggests this. Ketu in Sagittarius suggests that we need to break free from, you know, traditions, from beliefs. And Rahu there tells us we need to learn from the environment. We need to experience new things. We need to keep growing. We need to learn from our experiences. We should not be stuck up with whatever we think we know. Maybe there is much more to know. Maybe there is much more to learn. So this transit of Rahu Ketu already was suggesting change. Now with Jupiter coming into this picture, it's a very, very positive transit. And I would be covering the ascendants in the next video. We'll see you in the next video. It's bye-bye for now.